Welcome to the 2021 commencement ceremony here at Calvary Preparatory Academy. I'm Jared Beck, the school's director, and I'm privileged to be here with you today. It's hard to believe that this day is upon us after all that we've been through in the last 12 months. Looking back at last year's 2020 ceremony, there was so much uncertainty. We were encouraged by the speakers to trust God and to finish the race. Now here in 2021, we've pulled through the chaos, conquered fear. We trusted God and we held our ground in our positions where God placed us, to the effect that by staying faithful to God, we were able to be used by Him to provide you, the graduating class of 2021, an unhindered, uncompromised, rigorous Christian education despite all of the troubles in the world. I hope this legacy has made a mark in your life, and I hope it sticks with you in the years to come. Wherever God has you, hold your ground, be faithful, live the gospel in your immediate context, and let God handle the details. You made it through 2020 and now into 2021. You can trust Him as you move forward in the uncertainties of the future. He is a loving, compassionate, powerful God. In His hands, I commission you, the graduating class of 2021, as we begin our ceremony. Before I turn the platform over to some honorable and distinguished guests, I want to extend a special welcome to the parents, family members, and guardians of this senior class. Students, you made this journey 13 years ago, and you've completed this journey and have earned the best seats in the house. Congratulations. High school graduation is truly one of life's most memorable events. The express purpose of this ceremony is to recognize these 29 students who've successfully completed their program of study here at Calvary Preparatory Academy in order to receive a high school diploma. I would also like to recognize the teachers, administrators, staff, and board members for the roles that they've played to support our graduates to bring them here this day. Today's program consists of some wonderful guests who will be honoring us with heartfelt words of encouragement. In addition, we have the special privilege of being led in worship by our very own 2021 graduate, Genesis Sealer. I met Genesis many years ago at a conference when her parents were asking about the school. Since then, Genesis has excelled in her academics and has grown into an accomplished young woman. We are so proud of her and we are honored to have her lead us in worship. Before we do, let's pray. Lord, we thank you for these 29 graduates. We thank you for your hand in their lives. All these years, all these trials, all these circumstances, you've proven yourself faithful over and over. Lord, we thank you for their hard work and their determination. May you bless them as they go forward into this next chapter of life. Be honored today as we celebrate your hand in their lives and their faithfulness to your call. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Grace is alive in me. there's one thing I know, it's how you love me so. Jesus, you are more than enough for me.
Thank you so much, Genesis. That was amazing. At this point, we are going to be joined by a parent speaker. Our parent speaker today is Pastor Marlon Brown of Awake Vancouver. Marlon is also a member of the Parent Advisory Committee here at Calvary Preparatory Academy, and he serves as a lead pastor at his church. He has a wonderful wife and 5 children, and one of his children attends the school currently as an underclassman, and we are very honored to hear what he has to share with us today. Thank you, Marlon. I'll turn it to you.
Well, hello, Calvary Chapel Preparatory Academy, graduating class of 2021. Guys, how does that sound? You have to be so excited right now. Hey, my name is Marlon Brown, and I'm a pastor and missionary in Vancouver, Canada. More specifically to you, I have a son who attends CPA. We just finished our first year. He was in grade 8, so we are at the very beginning of the journey that we are celebrating the closing of for you today. Your principal, Mr. Beck, he asked me to come and share a few encouraging words with you. But before we get to that, I first just wanted to say, guys, congratulations. Seriously, seriously, congratulations. And if there are friends or family members in the room with you right now, guys, can we give them a round of applause? Round of applause, well earned. Guys, you deserve it. We are so very, very proud of you. As a pastor, I spend a large majority of my time each week preparing for messages and preach them every Sunday to our church. But I have to confess, this was definitely one of the hardest ones that I've had to prepare for. At first, I thought, Lord, give me one of those classic Bible verses, one of those really, really classic, encouraging Bible verses for these graduates. And so I thought of Joshua 1:9, right? Be strong and courageous, for the Lord our God is with you wherever you go. I thought of Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. Right? Classic, classic words of encouragement, perfect for your context right now. But the Holy Spirit said, no, it's not the direction I want to go in today. So then I thought, you know, maybe I'll share a funny memory from my early college days. Like how my first dorm room, it came with some fuzzy pets, but not the kind that you want. We had rats, and not the cute rats like in Ratatouille where they prepare the food for you. These were the rats that ate all of our food. I remember waking up one morning and my cereal and top ramen had just been ravished. And for those of you who don't cook, you will come to learn very quickly that cereal and top ramen are like the staples for our college students. So I almost starved to death in the beginning here. But once again, the Holy Spirit said, no, Marlon, that's not what I want you to talk about. And so I was seriously drawing a blank and for days racking my mind and in prayer, like, Lord, what do you want me to share? And then finally, the Holy Spirit, guys, spoke to my heart. And the Lord said, Marlon, just tell them about the story. Just tell them about the story. Now, guys, this isn't just some random story. And it's not even my story, but it is the greatest story ever told. It's a story that many of you have been told since your birth. Guys, it is the greatest story of all, the gospel of Jesus Christ. Graduates, did you realize that right now, your story is a mere reflection of the story? Think about it. Seriously, stop and think about it. The story of Jesus Christ is a commissioning story. The Bible centers around the story of a son who who, when he became of age, his father sent him away on a great mission. He had to leave the comfort and the splendor, the convenience of his own home, and journey to a foreign place. We know he had 12 messy roommates. They were constantly arguing and bickering. Many long days and long nights. And even thought about this. His mission, guys, it started with a great celebration. A gathering of family and friends at a party, of all places, in Canaan of Galilee. His mission would not be easy. You know the story. But it would forever change the world. Guys, we're talking about the story of Jesus. But graduates, guys, this is your story also. Today we are here to celebrate your commissioning story. You have been equipped, you have been trained, and now you have come of age. And the Father is sending you out on your great mission. Sure, you might have 12 crazy, messy roommates, right? But it is a grand mission. So today, celebrate. I mean, enjoy the festivities, enjoy your time with family and friends. But guys, tomorrow, there's much work to be done. Right? Tomorrow, the mission begins. And I want to read for you something about that mission from the book of Philippians. In chapter 2, starting in verse 5, it says of his mission, "Let this mind be in you which was also in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God did not consider robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, taking the form of a bondservant and coming in the likeness of man. And being found in the appearance as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even the death of the cross." Graduates, I wish I could tell you that this was going to be an easy mission, a very simple mission, but it's not. God is sending you out, and it is going to be difficult. There's going to be a lot of pain and strife and even death at times, but it's worth it. It's worth it because this mission, it ends in complete glory. Verse 9 says, "Therefore God also has highly exalted him and given him the name which is above every name. Through the name of Jesus, every knee should bow of those in heaven and of those on earth and of those under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father." His missions always end in glory, with great rewards, changing the lives both of you and of all of those around you, if you persevere to the end. And hey, graduates, side note, right? Always remember this. You are not alone on this mission, but God has given you a wonderful traveling companion who has been down this road before, and he'll be with you every step of the way, so just trust him, okay? Parents, I've thought a lot about you this week, and I'm praying for you. I know you must be filled with just a mix of emotions. But I want you to remember this also. You are a part of this great story. John 3:16, verse we all know. "For God so loved the world that what? He sent his one and only Son." Right? It was the Father who did the sending. Guys, remember, it was the Father who, I'm sure, being mixed with all these emotions, just like you are now, he sent the one and only Son whom he loved away into the world. Not because he wanted to, but because he knew that this was the only way for a lost and dying world to be saved. The only way. So parents, you've instructed them, you've prepared them, and now it's time to release them. And again, understand that the Father, he knows what you are experiencing right now better than anyone. He understands both the fear and the joy. He understands the worry and anxiety being balanced out with a sense of great pride and joy. The Father gets it. And as hard as it is for you now, or as hard as it'll be for you a few months from now, remember that this is all a part of His perfect plan. A plan that Ephesians, guys, tells us He laid out for your children before the very foundation of the world. So celebrate, rejoice with them today, and tomorrow send them out with all the love and joy and support that you possibly can, okay? And I know you because I know me. There's going to be that temptation to try and shield them and protect them from all the potential dangers and pitfalls that are in the world out there. But please remember this, right? Remember that this was the plan that God had for them before their lives began. And the mission that God has for us, believers, it always goes through what? The cross. So, side note, little reminder for you parents also. They have a good, good Heavenly Father who's going to be watching out for them, who has their back every step of the way. Amen. Can I ask you this? Can you please remind me of the very things that I'm sharing with you 4 years from now when I'm in your situation? All right. So, graduates, guys, this is your story. It is an addition. It is an addendum to the greatest story of all, the gospel. One of my favorite verses, Daniel 11:32, it says, "The people who know their God shall be strong and carry out great exploits." That's my prayer. I'm sure that's your parents' prayer. That's the staff's prayer. That's all of our prayer for you. That you will go forth from here and add many more pages of love and truth and faith to the greatest story of all, the gospel of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Hey guys, God bless you and may the Lord be with you.
Thank you once again, Pastor Marlon Brown, for those wonderful words of encouragement. At this point, we are going to transition over to our keynote speaker, but before we do, I'm not going to be introducing it. We have a special guest today, Pastor James Stretchberry, who's on the school board. He's going to lead us in the introduction to our keynote speaker. James Stretchberry is a dear friend of mine. I'm so glad to see him be part of this ceremony, and I'm really excited about the keynote speaker he's introducing us. So without further ado, I'll turn it over to Pastor Stretchberry.
Congratulations, 2021 graduates. I'm Jim Stretchberry, Vice President of the Calvary Prep Board, and on behalf of the board, we want to congratulate you today. What a wonderful day for you it's going to be, and it will be as you move on into the future. My hat is off to you, certainly, for your tenacity in finishing this year in very, very difficult situations. So I just want to give you a great bravo for coming to this place today. Our commencement speaker this year is a special treat. It's David Guzik, one of my friends for over 30 years, just a wonderful, delightful man. He's a pastor. He's a Bible teacher. He's the author of a widely read commentary. Millions of people around the world are reading his commentary every day, The Enduring Word, and also on the Blue Letter Bible site. I'm certain you will be blessed today as we hear from Pastor David.
Well, I want to thank Pastor Jim Stretchberry for that wonderful, warm introduction. But even more importantly, I want to give my heartiest congratulations to you, the 2021 graduating class of Calvary Preparatory Academy. This is quite an achievement for you graduates, but also for every one of you who is a parent or a supporter or a helper or a friend to a graduate. You as well have accomplished something wonderful, and today is a day for you to bask in some congratulations, in the knowledge of a job well done, and just to receive some of that. Now, my role here as part of this online graduation ceremony is to bring a word of encouragement to you graduates and to the associated family and friends from the Bible, from the Word of God. And I want to do that with you here today by reading to you from the book of Ecclesiastes, a book written by a man named Solomon many centuries ago. Now, if I was going to read to you something that was appropriate for graduates from the book of Ecclesiastes, I might read to you Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 12. This is what that verse reads. Of making of many books there is no end, and much study is wearisome to the flesh. I think that's a relevant verse to anybody who's a graduate, but really that's not where I want to dwell on here this day. Instead, what I want to do is begin reading to you just about a chapter before. Ecclesiastes chapter 11, verse 9 says this. Listen carefully. Rejoice, O young man, in your youth, and let your heart cheer you in the days of your youth. Walk in the ways of your heart and in the sight of your eyes. But know that for all these, God will bring you into judgment. I think this verse speaks profoundly to any person, especially a young person at a pivotal transition time in your life, just as each and every one of you graduates finds yourself in today. It tells you that this is something you can be happy about right now. Look at those words in verse 9. Rejoice, O young man, in your youth. What a beautiful, what a powerful thing it is for God to say, you're young, you have things to be happy about, enjoy them. God has put so many good and enjoyable things for us to legitimately receive in this world that it would be almost a sin, or maybe I should say virtually a sin, for us to not receive these beautiful, legitimate enjoyments and pleasures that God has given to us. And this is a day that you should enjoy. This is a day that you should celebrate because it marks a marvelous accomplishment. It marks a great milestone in your youth. This is something wonderful. Now, he goes on to say here in verse 9, let me read these words to you. Walk in the ways of your heart and in the sight of your eyes. Now, even though you are young, yet God has given you a wonderful measure of wisdom. For some of you, God's given you this wisdom just by the sake of what He's poured into you at your birth and the experiences you've had. You've grown up in a home and people have put wisdom into you. You've undergone an education and here you are as a graduate marking that education. In many ways, God has poured into you common sense, sense from the Bible, God's Word, sense from seasoned and wise people around you. These are things that have been poured into you, and therefore you can say, walk in the ways of your heart and in the sight of your eyes. Listen, graduates, there's been a lot good poured into you these past many years. Now God's Word to you is go out and walk in those things. Now, put out on the street and in everyday life the real wisdom and the practical knowledge that you've learned, and not just the practical things, but the principles of the more theoretical things you've learned through the years, they will have the opportunity to be lived out in real life. Now, it is true that God wants you in this sense to live out according to your heart, according to the sight of your eyes, especially as they've been more and more educated. And of course, just like for everybody, there's more and more education awaiting us in life. But you should not live as if what your heart thinks and what your eyes can see are the measure of everything. Let me explain to you what I mean. I'm going to start reading those lines again from verse 9. Walk in the ways of your heart and in the sight of your eyes. Now let me continue reading. But know that for all these, God will bring you into judgment. Now when I read those words, I wonder just how you may react. Whenever anybody opens up a Bible and starts talking about God's judgment, many people get nervous. Sometimes there's good reason for those nerves. But I want you to understand that there is a meaning behind God's judgment that we often disregard and is extremely relevant to you as you launch out into new paths of what God has for you in life. Here's the principle. There is a God in heaven who will bring all your life and all your works into judgment. That is a heavy truth, but it's also a truth that brings profound meaning to everything in life. Friends, this is the antidote, this is the antithesis to the premise that this life is all there is and what we do in this life really doesn't mean or count for anything. No, the truth from not only God's word, but from what he has written in our hearts tells us that this life is not all there is. And when we pass from this life to the next, we will come before a God who has examined everything that we have done. Now, again, I know that is a frightening thought for many people, and for some people, deservedly so. But I want you to know this, that it doesn't have to be a frightening thought. Here is a way to understand it, is that everything in your life can be rich with meaning if you do it as unto the Lord. If you do it as something that counts not just for now, this moment, but for eternity. There is a God who measures everything, and this means that everything has meaning in our lives. Everything is full of meaning if God will bring everything under his view. There is, and there will be, an eternal accounting for everything we do. Now listen, this day, your graduation day, isn't this a sense in which this is an accounting? Things have been reckoned up. The credits have been added up. Your courses have been examined. The tests have been taken. The evaluations have been in. And now here is your reward. Well, it's true for the present day, but it's even more true in an ultimate sense. There will be an eternal accounting for everything we do. And this is the complete opposite of the way of thinking that says that life here is meaningless and full of vanity. Everything has meaning. Everything has importance, both for the present moment and for eternity. If God cares about everything we do, then everything has meaning. Now, if we leave that thought behind, then life is empty and devoid of meaning. You know, there was a man who thought very deeply about the meaning of life. He thought about the price of a life that's lived without meaning. His name was Viktor Frankl, and one of his more famous books is a book that has had a big impact on me, or at least I hope it had. I read it many years ago. That book by Viktor Frankl was titled Man's Search for Meaning. Now, Viktor Frankl was a Holocaust survivor, and in that book, he speaks somewhat of his war experiences and his understanding of life. But Viktor Frankl was more than just someone who endured the Holocaust. He was also a psychologist. And in his practice, he studied why some people survived the Holocaust and why others did not. Now, of course, there's no universal answer to that question, but one common factor that Viktor Frankl found was he found that if someone felt that their life had meaning, then they were far more likely to survive the catastrophe known as the Holocaust. And he found that in his psychiatric practice after the war, when he met many people who lived their lives without any sense of meaning, they lived with a total and ultimate sense of meaninglessness, that their life amounted to nothing significant. This is what Frankl said. He said of those people, quote, "They are haunted by the experience of their inner emptiness, a void within themselves." And he says, this existential vacuum manifests itself mainly in a state of boredom. Friends, the life God has for you on this graduation day and forward is the opposite of boring. It is a life filled with meaning because everything in life is important to God. And today is a day you can set aside this and everything in front of you unto Him. That's why, and I'll conclude with this verse from Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 1. He says this, "Remember now your Creator in the days of your youth, before the difficult days come and the years draw near when you say, 'I have no pleasure in them.'" Dear friend, family perhaps of those who are graduating, if you are a graduate yourself, again, I want to congratulate you, but I want to call you to remember that not only do you have God in front of you for eternity to come, you also have God behind you as your Creator, the one who is the beginning of your life. Solomon said this, "Remember now your Creator in the days of your youth." Don't forget what he said back at chapter 11, verse 9. "Rejoice in your youth. It's a good thing. Be glad in it. But use your youth now to reflect on the reality of your Creator, where you came from, and on the reality of eternity in front of you, where you are going." Friend, I'm telling you, give the young years of your life to serving God and giving Him honor, and you will not regret it. Matter of fact, Solomon says here, I'm going to read to you again from Ecclesiastes 12:1, more of this verse. He says, "Before the difficult days come and the years draw near when you say, 'I have no pleasure in them.'" Friend, you realize the importance of that? You need to remember God as your Creator and as the eternal God to whom you will stand before. You need to Him remember that now before you enter into your future. Don't wait until you're in a world of trouble. Don't wait until your life seems empty and filled with confusion. Don't wait until crisis upon crisis has come upon you. Even today, a deservedly and worthy happy day, the day of your graduation, remember now your Creator in the days of your youth before the difficult days come. I guess what I'm encouraging you to do is to have a mind, to have a heart that appreciates eternity. Eternity, when it comes to what came before you, there's a Creator who existed before you ever did. And eternity, when it comes to what lies beyond you, there's a Creator to whom you and I and every person who's ever lived will someday give an answer to. This recognition of and living in light of eternity can make your life entirely different and put to such good use everything that's been poured into you under your years at Calvary Preparatory Academy, upon which from today you graduate, and congratulations to you with that. Let me end with this. Because your life has meaning for eternity, it has meaning right now. And I'll say this, if you believe your life has no meaning for eternity, then I question whether you really feel it has meaning now. In the 1930s, there was an Australian alcoholic named Arthur Stace. He was converted by hearing an inspiring sermon on the subject of eternity. The preacher, and I imagine the preacher to be a very energetic kind of preacher, he cried out, he said, "I wish I could shout eternity throughout all the streets of Sydney," because that's where Arthur Stace lived and the preacher was Sydney, Australia. Now, Stace was so moved by that preacher's sermon that he left the church and felt an immediate urge to write the word eternity on the pavement. So he had a piece of chalk in his pocket He took it out, and on the sidewalk, he bent down and wrote on that pavement the word eternity. Now, check this out. That man, Arthur Stace, was a chronic alcoholic, and he was hardly literate at all, half literate at best. He could barely write his own name legibly. But when he wrote the word eternity, he wrote it in the most beautiful, iconic copper plate script, and he left it there on the ground of Sydney, Australia. Now, he wrote it about 2 feet wide and spent the rest of his life. He lived until 1967, waking each day at about 5:30 in the morning, praying for an hour or so, and then going about the city of Sydney where he felt God leading him, and he would write eternity in beautiful script about 2 feet wide all over the streets of Sydney. Solomon would have approved of Arthur Stace and his perspective, his remembrance of eternity. So while you enjoy this amazing day in your life, remember, it's one day that adds in to your existence for eternity. And that means your life has meaning. Congratulations to the 2021 graduates of Calvary Preparatory Academy.
Welcome back, everyone. Thank you so much, Pastor Guzik, for those wonderful words of encouragement. Thank you, Pastor Stretchberry, for the introduction. We are honored to see both of you today in today's ceremony. And without further ado, we are going to be blessed one more time by our very own Genesis Sealer, who's going to lead us in another song of worship. Let's join Genesis as she does.
I will not be
Okay, we've arrived at the most important part of the ceremony, the presentation of diplomas. Every year, we have a special presentation where each teacher says a few words of encouragement and accomplishment of every graduate, and we'll have their picture up on the screen, and on normal years, we'll have them walk across the stage as well and be standing there as we present their diploma. And at this point, I'm going to turn it over to the teachers who have the special privilege and honor of sharing the accomplishments of each and every one of the graduating class of 2021. I'll turn it over to you, teachers.
Gracelyn Bohr. Grace is from Roswell, New Mexico, and has attended CPA for all 4 years of high school. She plans to attend Eastern New Mexico University upon graduation. Her hobbies include DC Comics and creating animations. She currently serves on the media ministry team at her church, Calvary Chapel, Roswell. Grace is a grinder. In the 3 years that I have known her, I've seen the ups and downs, but if one thing remains the same, it's Grace getting her stuff done. When the weight of the world felt so heavy, I was astonished again and again at her fight, her perseverance, and her steadfast determination to get up and keep moving forward. It wasn't always easy, but I could always count on Grace getting her stuff done and taking those steps. Grace, I am truly excited for the plans God has for you in your next big step. Rachel Cambra. Rachel currently lives in Bath, England, and has attended CPA for 2 years. She plans to attend Calvary Chapel Bible College in York, England after graduation. Her passions include art, such as watercolor and portraits. Rachel can also play a variety of instruments, including piano, guitar, ukulele, and she can sing. But her newest hobby is getting radical and dropping into the pit at the local skate park. Despite all the uncertainty these past 2 years, and while hitting a few frustrations and setbacks along the way, Rachel has remained steady and optimistic. I am so proud of how Rachel bounced back from her hardest moments and regained a passion to seek genuine learning rather than just coasting. Rachel, your perseverance, flexibility, and receptiveness to feedback these past few years display your dependence on Christ, and that has been such a witness to me. Congratulations on graduating high school.
Alyssa Cariaga. Alyssa comes to us from New Life Academy, one of our partner schools in Okinawa, Japan. She's an exceptional student, a wonderful young lady, but most importantly, Alyssa's an amazing child of God. I've been Alyssa's teacher here since her sophomore year at CPA. When we started our friendship, she was quiet, she was shy, incredibly studious. And when I asked her classmates to see if they had any ironic stories I could share today, I was told she's quiet, she's shy, and she's very studious, always with her head down in a book. I know that's just a smokescreen. Alyssa Cariaga is a powerful, a brilliant young lady. She has this wonderful sense of humor during our meetings. We laugh, we cry, and along the way we do learn. I've been blessed. I was able to come back to Calvary Preparatory Academy this year and be Alyssa's teacher for a final year. Alyssa will be attending the University of Maryland in the fall. She truly wants to study pharmaceutical science and perhaps be a pharmacist down the road. But pharmacy is only a road, an avenue, a vehicle, so she can follow her dreams of traveling. We've talked about exotic places in France, in Italy, around the world. Here's what I know though. There is a great, big, wonderful world out there, Alyssa, and it's waiting for you. Go out and enjoy it. I ask that you go with God. Know that I will always have you in my prayers. Goodbye and God bless.
Taylor Denham. Taylor is from Newport Beach, California, and has attended CPA for the past 2 years. She plans to attend a local community college upon graduation. Taylor has a passion for the creative arts, including writing, music, and acting. Upon completion of her associate's or bachelor's degree, Taylor may continue on to acting school. Taylor transferred to CPA her junior year, and she was not digging high school at that time. However, through the strength of Christ, through prayer and encouragement, and the maintenance of high expectations, Taylor is now consistently finding success in her studies and motivation in all she does. Taylor, I am so proud of you. You've made it through high school, and it has taken incredible strength. Remember to trust the Lord in all you do as you embark on your next adventure. Congratulations on graduating high school.
Sarah attended our school for all 4 years of high school. She is originally from Texas and spent 10 years living in Peru with her missionary family. In Peru, Sarah translated for visiting mission teams and studied Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Now Sarah has returned to Texas to get ready for her next steps. She's good at balancing a busy schedule. Sarah was recently promoted in her job at Chick-fil-A and is a talented baker and photographer. Next year, Sarah plans to take a gap year to travel. She plans to visit Ireland and other parts of Europe. After that, she will either start college general education courses or pursue a career as a hairstylist, flight attendant, or art teacher.
Isabel Fallour. Isabel is from Ottawa, Canada, and has attended CPA for all 4 years of high school. After graduation, she plans to attend Calvary Chapel Bible College in Costa Mesa. Isabel is a prolific writer and has been writing short stories and novels since she was 13 years old. Isabel is also the epitome of practicality. She dives headfirst into her passions and tends to leave everything else behind in the dust. This mentality, however, stems from a deep self-awareness of her own strengths. Isabel excels in her care for others, in the development and cultivation of deep personal relationships. Whether it be friends from school or church, or spending designated one-on-one time with her siblings, Isabel prioritizes the people that God has put in her life. For this reason, I can say with confidence that Isabel's future after graduation will be exceedingly bright and limited only by the measure of intentionality and grace that she pours about upon others.
Madison Fakara. Madison, what a pleasure it's been working with you at Calvary Preparatory Academy. You are truly an academic powerhouse. As I'm writing these words about you, I cannot help but reflect on the fact that your grades are 100% in every single class. Every meeting we talk, we laugh, we pray, you share your wonderful life with me. Madison, you have such fond memories as you share with me playing volleyball, playing softball, thrilling adventures with your crew, going to get ice cold boba teas, as well as just keeping your family centered in prayer and good thoughts. Even now at the end of your senior year, you continue to demand the very best from your education. Madison's entering the nursing program at Cal State University San Bernardino. She'll start there in the fall. And I hope and pray that, Madison, you continue to keep Christ centered in your life as you pursue your education as a nurse and continue to just serve others, to be that light, to be that love. Madison Fakara, go with God. Have an amazing future. Know that I will miss you. Bye-bye and God bless.
Victoria Gardner became one of my students 3 years ago. I've watched her bloom from a pretty quiet and shy young 10th grader to a confident young woman. Victoria is an amazing baker and opened up her own business selling her baked goods. When things slowed down this year because of social distancing, that did not slow down Victoria. She sought out a job at a local restaurant. I'm so proud of the initiative and the confidence that has grown in her these last couple years. I also admire how she is able to balance work and family life and school. She's a great student and does well in all her classes. Every time we meet, she's always well prepared and organized and ready to share what she has been doing in school that week. It's been a great pleasure to work with you, Victoria, these last 3 years. I'm very proud of you. Congratulations.
Thomas Hagen. Thomas, we've been through some ups and downs in 2020. It was a wild ride for both of us. You could say that we both picked ourselves back up after we'd been knocked down. We were down, but we were not out. God is not through with us yet. Thomas and I would work to help each other get back on track. And I will always be grateful for the support and encouragement that we shared. Thomas is a very talented musician and music mixer. He can raise the roof of your soul and spirit with his kind words, as well as his DJ skills. Thomas has a gift when it comes to prayer. I know that our Lord will open this door for you one day. Thank you for all of the years that you shared your wonderful writing skills with me. But I will truly, truly remember our discussions that we had about life and our Lord. Please enjoy college. There will always be time for you to go out and make your fortune. But I will always be here. If you just want someone to pray with, or just someone to talk to about life, about anything. Thomas Hagen, God bless. Enjoy your future. Go out and live.
Emily Hare. Emily is from Mission Viejo, California, and has attended CPA for 3 years of high school. After graduation, she plans to take a gap year. Emily is a gifted piano player, and she's been playing since the age of 10. Emily, you have had a rough go for high school, to say the least. Through the ups and downs, and more downs, and more downs, I've admired your willingness to hang in there, to be present, and to show up to meetings, to be real and be honest, and most of all, to choose hope. Hebrews 11:1 says, "Now faith is the assurance of things hoped for, the conviction of things not seen. Christ is our hope, and he is solid. Through the discouragements these past few years, I've seen you cling to Christ and bring you through, and he has brought you through. Maybe not in the way you expected, but nevertheless, you're here, a high school graduate." Isabella Harrell. Isabella lives in Rome, Italy, and has attended CPA for all 4 years of high school. She plans to attend Central Texas College online after graduation. Isabella serves in the worship team of her church, and for fun, she recently started a YouTube channel cataloging all her adventures. Faithfulness is the word that comes to my mind when I think of Isabella. Faithfulness in not only completing her work to the best of her ability and striving for mastery, but faithfulness in being real and honest in that learning process. Isabella also continually demonstrates faithfulness elsewhere in her church, community, family, and whoever God puts in her life. She does what she does with a pure heart to serve God and others in all she does. Isabella, I am so grateful for the person Christ has made you to be. Thank you for sharing that with me these past 3 years. And congratulations on graduating high school. You did it. Woohoo! Jade Harris. Jade lives in Phoenix City, Alabama, and has attended CPA for all 4 years of high school. She plans to take a gap year after graduation to work and to travel. Jade has an entrepreneurial spirit and has worked in restaurants and has a dream one day to open a coffee shop. She is also currently working in a hair salon and is pursuing getting her license to be a stylist as well. Jade has had one foot out the door probably since about her junior year. Jade is a hard worker in both her jobs and schoolwork, and I am so proud of her staying motivated despite her desire to be on the road ahead. Many blessings, Jade, on the path that God's take you. It has been an honor to be your teacher these past 3 years. Congratulations, you are now a high school graduate. Erin Jennings. Erin lives in Venice, Florida, and has attended CPA for 3 years. After graduation, she plans to attend the State College of Florida to start her undergraduate coursework. One of Erin's passions is hiking. She hikes almost every day and has won awards for hiking long distances under a certain amount of time. Erin has probably been equally excited for and dreading this day. To be done with high school, to stick her flag in this mountain, is such a relief. Yet it brings with it the question, what's next? The good news, Erin, is that although you may not know what's next, God knows and he cares for you. And he's promised to be with you. And indeed, he has a plan for your life. But more importantly, he has an adventure plan for you. You are an adventure with God. Proverbs 16:9 says, "A man's heart plans his way, but the Lord directs his steps." I am so excited, Erin, to find out where God directs your next steps.
Lea Mulasi Kalangwa. Wow, this young woman is an inspiration to all that know her. Through much adversity, Leah has persevered and is now graduating from CPA. She will be attending Calvary Chapel University in the fall. Leah, je te souhaite un avenir plein de joie et d'amour. Je suis très fière de toi.
I got to start working with Jason Katz this summer during the COVID summer. Jason was reserved and careful to let me get to know him initially, but it was only a matter of time before I was able to get him to open up and let me share the challenges that he was facing. You see, Jason had a battle to overcome this year that he was determined to conquer. I am so glad he was willing to trust me to work with him during such a difficult season, and he has made a significant progress, and I am so proud of you, Jason. So Jason is passionate, he's intelligent, and he's highly creative, and he's a fighter. So these strong passions would often work against him during his teen years, but these very same passions, as he continues to grow in harnessing them, will help him to accomplish powerful things. So he admits that one of his most valuable lessons that he learned while he was here at CPA was patience and how to avoid procrastination. So I was a witness to that, and it led to this day, the success of graduating and conquering this milestone. So proud of you, Jason. Don't give up the fight.
I have known Eliana Kirk since I became her teacher in September of last year. This fall, she will be attending George Fox University near her hometown in Oregon. In addition to her stellar academics, Eliana is a talented ballerina with a passion for riding horses. Most importantly, she has a great love for Jesus and desires his will for her life. Eliana, I have no doubt that God is going to use you in some special ways in the future. Congratulations on your graduation from high school.
Camilla Alejandra Mejia. Alec came to our school during her senior year with a wonderful group of young ladies and gentlemen from Quito, Ecuador. The COVID-19 virus has been crushing on people around the world, but Calvary Preparatory was blessed that Camilla came to our school. Alec is a fantastic creative writer who could share wonderful stories. She'd capture our weekly conversations. Alec is kind, she's passionate, about her life and her future. She's deeply committed to her family and her faith. Ale is currently trying to decide between universities in Ecuador, Canada, and the United States to continue her education. But I want to say thank you. Thank you for sharing a brief moment of your life with me, with our family here at Calvary Preparatory Academy. Ale, I'm dearly going to miss you. Goodbye and God bless.
Jordan Mercadante. I have had the pleasure of working with Jordan for a year and a half now. She is full of energy and has so much in front of her. Jordan will take a gap year to figure out her next steps. She may pursue a career in fashion, design, art, or even makeup. Whatever Jordan decides to do, she'll be great. She is a hardworking young woman, and it has been such a blessing to meet with you every Wednesday morning. I wish you so much success in your future, Jordan.
Alexander Mayer. Alex comes to us from Canada. Alex is graduating from Calvary Preparatory Academy as a student, but he's leaving this school truly as my dear friend. We have spent many hours praying for each other and our families. Along this journey, there's just been so many special places. So many special moments. Alex is a special place in heaven for young men like you. You need to know that. Every week we would pray for those struggling in our school, for his family, for those struggling around the world, and never would Alex ask for prayers for himself. Alex, you and I are kindred souls. We know that we must be strong and fight this fight. Alex, please remember that life's going to knock you down. It knocked me down, and you helped me get back up. Alex, I'm going to always be here to help you get back up. I'll be here to give you that helping hand that we don't always feel. I will always remember our deep conversations, our wonderful moments of laughter, all the special times we would share. While meeting with Alex, once he screamed, "Hold on, Mr. A, there's a moose outside." And he used that famous Canadian adjective, "eh?" And it was the only time I ever heard him use it. But I've called him out on it before. Alex, you're incredibly talented. He's very talented in computers, an amazing writer. Alex's dream, though, is to go on to be an attorney. He's got some adventures ahead of him. Alex, with all these adventures, I'm going to ask you, please, send me a postcard along the way, because this is not goodbye. It's only for now. Only till I go to my mailbox, I open it up, and I get a postcard of where you are in the world. Alex Meyer, you will be missed, and I will always keep you in prayer. Be good and God bless.
Kendall has attended our school for the past 2.5 years. She is located in Missouri and is a competitive cheerleader and dancer. In addition to her team practices, she helps teach a tumbling class for smaller children. Kendall plans to become a neurosurgeon, and she has been accepted to her dream college, Xavier University of Louisiana. Kendall is an energetic and responsible young lady. She thrives on being busy, productive, and interacting with others. In addition, she is not afraid to ask questions. Kendall's skill at making sound decisions when short on time will serve her well in her future as a physician.
Hi, I had the privilege of working with Evan Myers from the summer before his 9th grade year. He took a website design class with us just to check us out, and I thought, oh no, he's not coming back because that's a really hard class. But not only did he come back, he did it stellarly, if that's a word. Evan was relentless and persistent about getting what he wanted, and he wanted to get in and out of high school and to do it well on the way. And that's what he did. So he did dual enrollment with Saddleback College, and he took summer school classes with us and graduated back in January. Not only just January, he graduated at the beginning of December because he was persistent and he did it with all A's. Way to go. So after high school, Evan was going to initially pursue economics and computer science at Saddleback College and was able to get half of his credits towards his AA while he was still here in high school. Now he intends on transferring to UCI to study film and media to become a video editor. So I'm confident that Evan will accomplish this and the same determination and drive that he conquered his high school career. So proud of you, Evan. Congratulations.
Clarence, my young brother, been a great gift in my life this year, a gift from God. I returned to teaching here at Calvary Preparatory Academy again and was blessed to be Clarence's teacher for his final year at our school. Clarence's first teacher here was Miss Tammy Lashley. When I asked Mrs. Lashley, give me any background, anything I could expect with Clarence, she raved about the quality of this young man's character. She was absolutely correct. An old saying says it's not the years, it's the mileage. Well, Clarence and I have put on some miles in this year that's been amazing. And not just from Okinawa to LA and back to Okinawa again, but all that we've talked about, all that we've prayed about, and all that we've worked on. Clarence's future will be interesting. Clarence is a Singapore citizen and will be returning to Singapore to serve 2 years in the military that's required from all of their high school graduates in Singapore. He does want to continue his education. He's going to focus in many areas, many fields, but he wants to focus in the areas of computers. We've talked about military intelligence. We've talked about artificial intelligence, robotics, cyber crimes, so many different areas in technology. I'll remember Clarence mostly, though, not for his mastery of calculus, not for his mastery of physics, but I'm going to remember Clarence for always is his love of family. Truly, as he spoke to us about me, about his grandmother and being a mentor and his mom and his family, just amazing. Clarence, you will always, always have a place here in California set at our table so you can stop in and get a good bite to eat, grab a place to sleep along the way. Because over this last year, Clarence, we've become family. I will never forget you. Good luck on your future. God bless.
The word grace is defined as seemingly effortless of charm, of movement and form, to be generous, to be helpful, and to show goodwill. These words remind me of my student Grace as I envision her dancing across the stage. Grace is balanced being a full-time dancer as well as a straight-A student. She is one of the most dedicated and hardworking students that I know. She strives to excel in all that she does. She also lives out her definition of her name in her school assignments. Because not only are they high quality, but they are full of compassion and wisdom and gentleness. At the beginning of her time with his here at Calvary Prep, she had some obstacles that she had to overcome, but she triumphed over them. I'm very proud of you, Grace. In the fall, Grace plans to attend Grand Canyon University and to seek an athletic training major. Congratulations, Grace. Nice work.
Emma Roots. Emma is from Tucson, Arizona, and has attended CPA for 2 years. After graduation, she plans to attend Colorado Christian University. In her free time, she enjoys photography and blasting down the pavement on her longboard skateboard. Emma is a gem. From whatever angle you look, she shines. Whether it be academics, clubs, athletics, volunteering, work, or connecting with people, Emma excels at them all. She has a big heart and genuinely cares for those around her. She also loves to learn and improve her many skills. Emma, I think you were ready for college 2 years ago, but today I'm so excited to say, congratulations, you did it. Amazing job completing high school.
I was Isaiah Scott's teacher for the last year and a half of his high school education. Isaiah was part of our independent study program, which can be pretty difficult for a lot of students, but it fit him well and he excelled in it. He always did great work when he was with me, and he even graduated a semester early. Way to go, Isaiah. This next fall, Isaiah will be attending the Jerusalem Study Tour with Calvary Chapel Bible College, and then he hopes and plans to attend the Calvary Bible Institute Peru to develop his skills for missionary or ministry purposes in the future. Excellent work, Isaiah, and I look forward to hearing how God uses you in the future. Congratulations.
When I became her teacher 2 years ago, Genesis lived in Canada. Now she lives in Arizona. Quite a change. She has attended CPA for all 4 years of high school, and upon graduation, she plans to attend Central Arizona College. She is deeply involved in her church, serving in the children's ministry and worship teams. She also has many years of experience as a pre-professional ballet dancer. The ability to keep high standards for oneself, yet demonstrate enormous understanding and patience for others, is a quality that I think characterizes Genesis. Like the rising of the sun, I could always count on Genesis to be prepared and demonstrate mastery on her subjects. Yet she also prays and cares deeply for those around her, especially those who don't know Jesus yet. Genesis, it has been an absolute honor and privilege to be your teacher these past 2 years. I am so excited for what God has in store for you next. Congratulations on graduating high school.
Hi, Samantha Smith was a beautiful gift given to me this school year. I started with her during COVID summer, and at the time she was really going through a difficult season, and she had to fight through some very difficult circumstances. I'm so proud of her and blessed to stand here today as a witness to her transformation to overcome this school year. Her strong faith in God, her love for her family, and hope for a better tomorrow drives her forward. So one of the ways that Samantha chose to fight through some of her adversities was to serve others. Samantha joined the student leadership team in the fall, and she was voted class vice president, actually school vice president. She worked on the newsletter team in addition. And in the spring semester, she started an art club on campus for art lovers and also for an opportunity for students to heal if they were going through some emotional trauma. She is such a leader. Samantha plans to move to Oklahoma when she graduates to attend community college and to pursue a career. She is undecided on what she will be as of now, but judging by how she has persevered through this school year, I am confident that she will find just the right path that will lead to a promising future. And she'll probably bless a few people along the way. Samantha, I'm so proud of you. Congratulations.
Nathan Snyder is an outstanding and excellent student. I enjoyed working with Nathan this last year. Nathan took honors classes with us, and he also took classes at the local community college. Nathan had a pretty full year as he took on an part-time job, as well as his father was deployed, and so had a little bit more responsibilities at home, I'm sure. But he was able to balance all that was on his plate. Nathan is also an avid and competitive swimmer. He hopes to compete in an out-of-state college in the future. First, he plans on attending a local community college and then transferring. He would like to transfer to a college in Michigan called Hillsdale. I know Nathan will do well and excel in all that he does. Way to go, Nathan. Congratulations.
Owen Takamoto. This young man has a bright future waiting for him. He is a very talented musician and can play multiple instruments. He continues to persevere through all obstacles and does it with a smile. He and his amazing family live in Japan and are part of a growing church community. Owen loves his family and he loves the Lord. He will take a year off to decide what adventure comes next. I'm so thankful to know you, Owen. I wish everything great for you today and every day.
Okay, this is the moment that we've all been waiting for. Graduating class of 2021, please take a moment to make sure that your tassels are correctly positioned on the right side of your caps. And as you do so, I'm going to be presenting the benediction for the graduating class of 2021. Let's do it. At this point, I have the honor to present to you these 29 graduating seniors. I have reviewed the program of study, the courses they've completed, their merits and accomplishments, and it's with great excitement and celebration that I present to you the graduating class of 2021. Seniors, take your tassels and move them from the right to the left. Congratulations. This marks the close of our 2021 commencement ceremony. Thank you so much for joining us. Please stick around to see some of the credits where we take a moment to thank the individuals, churches, ministries, and others who've all contributed to make this day so successful. Thank you, everyone, and God bless.